The eternal God is thy refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. The Lord gave, and the Lord taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Though he slay me, yet will I see my God. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and he that shall stand on the latter day upon the earth, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and are saved. Lord has been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, the word God. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Shall we praise God this evening? Shall we praise God this evening? Hallelujah! This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah! I want to take this opportunity to welcome everyone to Park Hill and welcome to El Bethel Tabernacle, where we will be celebrating the life of our departed sister, Sister Brown. Glory be to God. She has lived her life. Glory be to God. She is no more with us. But I pray and hope that she make it into the kingdom of God. That's the most important thing, that she make it in. Hallelujah. It's not how you start in life, it's how you finish at the end of your journey will determine your destiny. Hallelujah. Whether you make it in or you go to hell. So let's all celebrate the life of our sister this evening. Amen?
Amen.
Let's celebrate the goodness of God. As I turn over the service to our chairperson.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This time I just want to take the opportunity again to welcome each and every one of you into the house of God, and on behalf of Elder Richards and the members of the El Bethel Tabernacle, we just want to welcome you to this Thanksgiving service of the late Sister Anne Brown. We come to celebrate Jesus. We know that she was a child of God, and we believe that she's in a better place. And today we just want to celebrate with the family, give God praise and thanks for all he has done and for what he is doing. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God. At this time, you are already standing, so we're just going to join and sing our chorus hymn on our hymn sheet this afternoon, How Great Thou Art. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. We come to give thanks this evening. We come to give thanks. Hallelujah. We're in the presence of God. We are in the house of the Lord. And this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder, you say the world thy hands has made. I
Lord.
We ask for an intervention, O Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you thanks and praise and honor and glory. I commend this service to your hand, O Lord God.
Jesus.
And Father, I pray for, Lord God, for the very family, Lord. The one, those who are suffering, O Lord, and those who are feeling the heart, O Lord God, that they realize that you are our comforter. You are our strength, you are our healer, you are our deliverer. And then, Lord, cast all the cares upon thee, O God. And Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for deliverance, if it was courage, if it was strength, if it was guidance. And as we are bound, O Lord God, to go forward into our service, O Lord, I pray for blessings, I pray for the anointing. I pray that thou take control of everything, O Lord, that the Bible said in the house, O Lord God. I know that all, O Lord God, someone may turn their life unto thee, O God. The Father, in the name of Jesus, I command this service right now into my hand. Blessed in everything, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Blessed be God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let me remind you again, we are here to celebrate the life of our sister. We're going to celebrate and we're going to give God praise and thanks. Hallelujah. Praise God. Open out to our worship team as we take us to a time of praise and worship in Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Praise the name of Jesus! We are here to celebrate the life of our sister, knowing, hallelujah, that he was the child of God. Hallelujah! The angels in heaven, they are rejoicing. Let us rejoice in, hallelujah, let us rejoice in the presence of the Lord. This evening, realize that Jesus, he said that I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you. Hallelujah! It's God alone this evening, it's God all by yourself. Hallelujah!
Jesus going to prepare.
I'm far away, oh, far away.
Thank you.
the name of the Lord. Thank you very much, worshipers. We want to give God praise and thanks this evening. One of the songs say, if you miss me, don't come searching. Hallelujah. Praise God. It's good to be prepared and ready to go with the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. You can have your seat at this time. We'll continue in order of service. At this time, we'll have the first scripture reading from Psalms 91, 1 through 12. And we'll have Vanessa James' granddaughter to read the first piece. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Good afternoon. The first scripture reading will be taken from Psalms 91, verse 1 to 12, and it reads, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His trust shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that fleeth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in the darkness. For the destruction that wastes at noonday, 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eye shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou bash their foot against a stone. Here ends the scripture reading.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This time I'm going to invite you to stand as we get the second. Okay. Him. And we're going to sing the second hymn that is trust and be on your own.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Our second scripture reading, taken from Matthew chapter 25, 1 to 13, and it will be read by Alencia Brown.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Alencia Brown and Brown Daughter. I know it has been left out.
Okay.
The second scripture reading is taken from St. Matthew chapter 25, reading from verse 1 to 13. Here begin it. Then shall the kingdom of heaven be like unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps with them, and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all stumbled and slept. And at midnight there were a cry made, "Behold, the bridegroom cometh. Go ye out to meet him." Then all the virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, "Give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out." But the wise answered, saying, "Not so, lest there be no oil enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourself." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came. And they that were ready went in with him to the marriage. And the door was shut. Afterwards came also the other virgins, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered and said, "Verily I say unto you, I know ye not. Watch therefore, for ye know not neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh." This is the word of the Lord.
Praise God. Praise God. Watch. Yes. Lord, the midnight hour when the Son of Man cometh. Praise God. At this time, we have tributes now, and the first tribute, Church of God of Holiness, we welcome you at this time. Tribute.
In the middle of the night, when my back is against the wall, King Jesus taught me how to pray. I greet everyone in the wonderful name of Jesus this afternoon. Hallelujah, indeed God is wonderful. We are not serving a dead God, and we are not here to celebrate the dead. We are here to rejoice and to build up the family. And our brethren, let us stay together. Let us pray together. So that we can be together. In the name of Jesus. Once more, I bring you greetings from Church of God Holiness this afternoon. My name is Deaconess Cotilla McDowell Lewis of Connery from the Church of God Holiness North Union. I'm here to give a tribute for Sister Ann Brown Wall, who was a part of our fellowship in the Church of God since 2003. Us at the church, we had a good working relationship. We took part in, Us at the church, we had a good relationship with Sister Ann Wall. She took part in most of the activities of the church, from Sunday school, fasting service, communion service, also the woman's fellowship. She was not one of whom easily adapt to change, but when she got it, she got it. She had a great love and respect for her pastor and his wife, who are not here this afternoon because of sickness. Pastor always made it a point of duty to visit her, listen to her problems, and try to help her to see things God's way. We are not sure she always agreed, and we are not sure she was always agreed and followed the instruction given. For those of us who know Sister Anne knows that she liked to do things her way. But the purpose of the church is to create an environment for all believers to have access to God. For this we are sure that Sister Anne got all these opportunities to make good of her service. To God, whether or not she uses all those opportunities to get into a right relationship with God, eternity will tell. There's many times when pastor and some of the saints will visit her house and in her shut-in moments and sing with her and serve communion. She never said no to these actions. So therefore, time came when she had to say goodbye. We are sorry that it is so soon. We pray for the immediate family, children, husband, to do better, to do even better than Anne did. Hope that you all will come together and don't be left behind an unfinished task. Let light perpetually shine on her. God bless you all. Hallelujah.
Upon the Lord. good afternoon to each and
every.
You have to give. You see this lady here? She was a nice sharing and giving person. You don't have to ask her. As long as you and she are friends, she giving you. She was my neighbor, but me and she not been agree. Because hey, never ever you tell she wrong, you break for the whole day. You not talk to your butt. Where for she give, she was a nice lady. That's my.
Oh, Thank you.
I love Anne, a special woman. Every time I pass to go by my home, Anne always under the porch. And she will give me an encouragement. You're going to your house? We say yes. We say, he has said, right, come now. We say, I don't put in two windows. They say yes. That you have to have technical and do as you can. And for that little encouragement, I am encouraged to push forward with my little home and with you. Thank you, Anne, for your little encouragement. And to the family, if you don't know God as your personal Savior, I'm encouraging you all to know Him.
All right.
Know Him now, because we are living in the last days. As you can see, you might look at me and you might say, we're not young girl living in the last days. Yes, we are living in the last days. Look at what is going on around us. Please accept God into your life before it's eternally too late. And with that, I'm going to sing just one verse of the song because I love to sing.
Right.
And this is a little encouragement for you all.
You've been in your storm seems like forever. Lies of confusion.
and they are from the Leslie. But we move on.
Alright.
And then 2003, I met that day. That's when we began to worship and our coach of North Union.
Alright.
What I know most about that, she could have made a song she did.
Okay.
And I always asked her, how do you get your song she did like that? And she promised she would have given me a recipe. And then I gave me a recipe.
There's a bright day. It's all Mr. Fellowship together, my children then, then I'm going away. And I feel so dumb and hard to do that I have never seen that opportunity to go back to God. I feel so bad to you. But my word for me today, I might not let the gold away from the one. Along with my husband, we all go to a ready, my word for me is with me. I have even lost my wife together. The Lord him cost us so very much. But you know God knows this. The Lord him and the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I just want to preach to you the Lord. If you don't have said the Lord as your personal and Savior, don't wait until it's too late. Because it's too late, shall be your cry when Jesus of Nazareth passed by. You see how life is going today? Time is very sharp. So I want you to deliver me if you don't take Christ as yet. Before time is too late. God's going to send up a good wife for you, a good wife just like that. If you only trust him, if the trust is on your way, there is no other way. Just trust him, my man, and one day, he's going to send up a good wife for you. I just want to keep the faith. Because God is on the way. You will not be ready to suffer. He will support you, and he will come back. And when you see God, the God has blessed you.
Kamala Masarawal, known by name as Angrom, was born on October 11, 1963, as the eighth of nine siblings to parents Thelma Collette and Nathaniel Brown. In 1979, Anne moved to Barbados, where she resided for a few years, finishing her secondary education before moving back to St. Vincent. In 1985, Anne gave birth to her first daughter, Valencia, and later on in 1984, Anne gave birth to her first daughter, Valencia, and later on to her second in 1985, Valencia. She then worked as a farmer for Father Knight and family for a few years passing. Anne in her years was known as the life of the party. You could have found her outside Boston Africana Disco, selling rotis with her good friend Mona Dario, or with her close friends Mona, Beatley, or Brenda baking cakes and bread on the weekend. In 2002, Anne met Romulus Ward, who then became her husband later on in 2012. As this new chapter of her life began, she also used it as an opportunity to dedicate her life to Christ. As years passed, her struggle with diabetes slowed her down physically, but that never stopped the high-spirited individual that she was. Many who crossed paths with her can relate to how giving she was. She always had something to give anyone who passed and didn't take us. Anne shared a special relationship with her three grandchildren, Amari, Vanessa, and Alicia. She was always excited to see and spend quality time with them. She always asked them, "Have you eaten?" and sent them straight to the kitchen to get whatever they wanted. She spent many moments with her grandson Amari, some more mischievous than others, but regardless, the love she had for her grandkids was unconditional. Her husband Romulus met the world to her. She would get so excited to hear his voice on the phone telling her he would be home soon. Remy would spend his time from work with her watching movies, braiding her hair, or old talking by the bedside. Anne shared many moments with her family and friends, all of whom would continue to speak of the caring and loving soulful person she was. All of whom would live to remember her laughter, her smile, and her generosity. All would bond to the fond memories they shared with her, and even though she would no longer live to create more memories, her soul lives on in our hearts. Make sure it's good peace.
Thank you very much.
you at this time, because it's time that you have to sing on right now. Turn him. After we should get the song from the last moment. So let us stand or turn him when the road is called on him.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and can shall be no more, and the morning breaking dawn arise again. When the spirit of the Lord shall be no more, and the Lord shall rise again. When the road is full of yonder, when the road is full of yonder,
extend my condolences to the immediate family, the husband, children, grandchildren, and I did not know my neighbor from Calder. I want to acknowledge the Bronx this evening. The Bronx this evening, Mr. and Mrs. Brown and their daughter, praise God. And I also want to acknowledge the Wilsons, Kerry and Cuthbert Wilson. Cuthbert Wilson is my senior. Amen. I want to acknowledge their presence here this evening. I believe that they are related to the immediate family. And I also want to acknowledge the butlers from Canary, those sisters who live in on the stretch there. Hallelujah. Their mother and me, we goes well. In the days when we used to come to Park Hill, them used to travel from Canary to come to Park Hill. When, amen, to God be the glory. Great things he has done. Hallelujah. So I want to extend my deepest condolences to the immediate family, to the friends and loved ones of our departed sister, those of Park Hill and those of Canary. Amen?
Amen.
To God be the glory. Praise God. To die is gain. To die is gain. Corinthians chapter 1, verse 21 to 23. For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. If I am to go on living in the body of this will mean fruitful labor for me. Yet, what shall I choose? I do not know. I am not torn between the two. I desire to depart and be with Christ. Which is better? For far. Which is better? To die for the Pilinchi escape. Many people will achieve many things in this life, glory be to God. But it's how you finish at the end of your journey here on earth. Some people start good and they end bad. Some people start bad and they end well.
Yes.
But it's how you finish at the end of your journey. Glory be to God. It doesn't matter. You set a plate and come back and eat the bread of sorrow. To die is gain.
Yes.
You will get a glorious house, glory to God. That's the word of God tells us in the book of Job, chapter 14 and verse 14. Job says, if a man die,
all right.
Will he live again? Yes, we will live again, glory to God. We will live again, hallelujah. We will have the power of life on that day, glory to God. He said, ready or not, my Lord is coming. Are you ready? Many people live many restless life. My brother, not of all. You see what I'm saying, God?
Yes.
I know you are sad.
Yes.
No, you are sad, glory to God. People, you have Christian people jumping.
Yes.
You have Christian people who are lead worship or take part in church.
Yes.
And you will see them, glory to God, hallelujah. We are serving God, hallelujah. And God said, I will come coming back for church. And then because part of it is being close. Let's live our lives to please Almighty God. Just when you live this life, you are the glorious house. Not a house made from man, hallelujah. But a house that made from God. A house that is sanctified. We will inherit it. And if you die, it's die. It's better to die again, a glorious body.
All right.
When you die in Christ, Lord, my loved ones, my brothers and sisters, you will get a glorious fellowship.
Yes.
Yes. What have you done here? Sometimes neighbors don't want to talk to neighbors. Parents don't want to talk to parents. That doesn't want to talk to parents, glory to God. But one day, all this will done. One day, all this will done. All this will come to an end. But make sure that when you die in Christ, that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Yes. Amen.
Live. But if you live, you live to the Lord.
Yes.
And if you die, Sister Brown, you die to the Lord. God give us life.
Yes.
He give us free will to choose. Choose in this day whom you will serve.
Yes.
We are not supposed to serve them. We have to respect them. But many Christians are serving the pastor. Glory to God. We do not come here to do that. We come here to serve Almighty God.
Yes.
To die is what?
Yes.
It's to gain. Surrender all.
Yes.
You want to swim again? Surrender all. Where is the husband? Somebody show the husband to me. Somebody show the husband to me. Show the husband to me.
Show me another word, please. Is Mr. Brown? Can I say this, Mr. Brown?
Yes.
Mr. Wall. You know so many things, nice things about your wife. I could help you. Can I help you?
Yes. Amen.
You have so many good things about your wife. But that will not guarantee you a place in the kingdom of God. Hot so John, your heart is finished. If you want to see her, you have to surrender all.
Yes.
Surrender all unto Almighty God, hallelujah. And you will meet your wife again, glory to God. Children and grandchildren, brothers and sisters, I am talking to everyone, friends and loved ones. If you want to see Sister Wall again, you have to surrender all.
Yes.
The word of God, this song will tell us, he that have a clean hand and a pure heart shall be able to stand.
That's the Lord, glory, man.
You did a good job. Not many men like you will do these things. Sometimes they will bring in someone to take care of your strong man. Glory be to God. To die is gain. For the world will live as though that they will not die. But for the Christians, to die is gain. Glory be to God. Because it's different. We are children of God. We are particular, hallelujah. We are peculiar, hallelujah. We does not eat any and anything, hallelujah. We does not talk any and anything. Glory be to God. You will gain a better inheritance. A better inheritance. Sometimes we have with children them. We make wills. We make all sort of things for our children them. And before our parents close their eyes, sometimes they take the children, the parents, and put them in a home and do what they want to do. Glory be to God. But that does not guarantee you a place into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Church, our final reward is not here on earth. We are just pilgrims, hallelujah, passing through. We just camping for a while. And one day, Christ will return and take his chosen people to reign with him. We just camping, glory be to God. We just camping, my brothers and sisters. It's just only for a while. We just camping here on earth. One day, hallelujah, Christ will come. Christ will bust the eastern cloud and come back for his chosen people. Are you ready? Are you ready? If Christ have to come now, let me see the hands of all those who are ready. Glory. Church, ready or not? Whether you're ready or not, Lord God, ready or not, Lord God, he is coming again. Ready or not, if you are not, he is coming again. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what position you hold in this life. Hallelujah. Ready or not, Christ is coming again. You will be present. You will be praying. Hallelujah. You will be coming to shut up.
Ready
or not, if you're not ready, but Christ is ready for you.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Where will stand eternal?
yours. You can accept that the pastor has given you the opportunity to surrender all of you today. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Pastor Key. Thank you very much. I want all the family to come, the grandchildren and husband. I want you all to just come. They're going to pray now. Sister. I want you all to come. Praise God. Before I pray, I just want to, while they are coming, I just want to give my condolence to the family. On behalf of my family and the family of the church, our greatest condolence. I know Sister has already said it already, but I'm going to say my greatest condolence. Praise God. This is it, all. You all come. We're going to pray. You see, I know that is something we can't get accustomed to. I lost a brother just a couple of months ago, back to back. And I know who it is. And we all have to come together. You see, sometimes when we have death in the family, sometimes there are differences among family members. But we got to understand that one of these days, that all of us here, death will strike.
Yes. Oh, yes.
But it's not the death, it's how we die.
That's right. Yes. Yes.
In this time that we are living in, we got to live together.
Yes.
I heard a sister stand up there just now and she said she regret she didn't go and visit.
Yes.
You don't want to be regret tomorrow if you have differences and something happen and you have to stand up with a conscience and say, I should have talked to my sister. I should have talked to my brother. I should have talked to. So before I pray that you all will make it right.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Because God wants to do something in His heart.
Jesus. Oh, yes.
For those who don't know Jesus as their Lord and Savior, do it now.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord, we know that you are God and you made us. And God, you have given us time and all, Lord God. And none of us know when our time will come. So God, I pray at this time for this family. At this time of grieving, Lord God, for their loved one. God, I pray in the name of Jesus for the husband. I pray for the children. I pray for the grandchildren. I pray for the cousins and the aunts and everyone of God who are grieving for the sister, Lord God. And I pray right now that you will touch them, Lord. And as Jesus was going to leave, he said, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me, my Father's house. There are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you, he said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And one day I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you will be also.
Amen.
I pray that they will not own us though they don't have hope, Lord God. But God, they will, God, see fit to surrender everything unto you in the name of Jesus. Touch them right now, oh God.
Yes.
Minister to their needs in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I pray in the name of Jesus that you will be a comforter, Lord. in the name of Jesus. Have your way right now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you all. And go with God. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord, sister.
Thank you. This. You got combat.
Go down, sir. Don't go over here. Keep down, sir. Keep down. Careful.
Careful.
Put them under the knee, please. As the camera go over here.
Yeah.
Wait, hold on.
Shall we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Shall we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Glory be to God. As we come to lay the final remains of our departed sister, we lay today to rest a mother, a wife, a grandmother, a sister, an aunt, a community person. Amen. To God be the glory. This is our final resting place until that great getting up morning when Christ shall return and bust the eastern cloud. Hallelujah. If she make it in, hallelujah, she will have a place in his kingdom.
Amen.
Glory
Amen.
Be to God. Amen. And before we go any further, we're going to ask Elder Clef to do the prayer for us.
Father, we want to thank you for being so good to us. You have brought us thus far, Lord God. And at this time, O God, as we gather to lay the remain of our sister, I pray a blessing upon our life, Lord. I pray that everything will be done in decently and in order. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Yes. Yes.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? One thing have I desire of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Some of us have shared through these passing years a wonderful companionship, fellowship with our beloved and faithful sister, Sister Brong. Many blessed, hallowed memories come to us in these moments, which we shall always cherish. Her faithfulness, friendliness, and consecrated life will continue their radiances and testimony in our lives, our church, our community, in the name of Jesus Christ, whom we love and serve for as much as is pleased. Almighty God, unto his great mercy, we therefore commit our departed sister, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, in the certain hope of the resurrection of life eternal to our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our corruptible body, that it may be like unto a glorious body, according to the work of his mighty power, whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Father, we give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory for your loving kindness and tender mercies. Lord, we present the bereaved family in your hands today in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, Lord, we pray that you will continue to strengthen them, oh God. Lord, that you will continue to be with them, oh God. Lord, that they will continue, oh God, in the steadfast love of you in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, Lord, we pray for the husband, we pray for the children, we pray for the grandchildren, we pray for the brothers, nieces, and nephews in the mighty way, oh God. Lord, have your way in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. As we sing, anybody have the leaflet? Yes. I must have the Savior with me.
Yeah.
How is yours today? We could sing this one. Oh Lord, my God, when I am not someone dumb, consider thy one thy hands of me.
Thank you. That's right.